All right, so there is this thing that I want to talk about.
In an electrical circuit, the circuit breakers are supposed to protect the circuit from excess current, which could cause damage to your load or to your wiring cables. Now, under what circumstances should the breaker trip? If your breaker keeps on tripping, what do you have to do? In this video, I'll be talking about how to know why your breaker is tripping and then how to rectify that problem.
So this is a distribution board with various MCBs inside. MCB simply means miniature circuit breaker. All right, and so in every installation, these breakers are there to protect the cables and the load from excess current. Excess current can destroy your load. Excess current can cause fire. And so at any time that there is excess current as a result of fault or short circuit, then overload. When you put too much load on the breaker, too much load means that the current rating of the load is higher than the current rating of the breaker. When it happens like that, the breaker will trip. So the breaker goes off when the load has a fault, and that fault results into excessive current. When there is a short circuit between two conductors in the wiring, and then when there is an earth fault. All right, so these are the reasons why your breaker can go off. Your breaker can also go off as a result of a surge, and this can happen as a result of problems with the main grid lines, or it can also happen as a result of lightning. So anytime the breaker trips, the right in it, you have to know why the breaker went off. If the breaker went off as a result of short circuit, that is caused by a known source.
For instance,
if you brought a faulty kettle or a faulty heater into your socket, and then the moment you plug in the faulty iron, your breaker goes off, then that tells you that your load, the equipment you are connecting to the wiring, might be faulty. All right, so at that point, you know that the breaker has tripped as a result of the faulty load you are connecting. So in that case, you just remove the load and then you go and then switch on the breaker back. That is okay. Now, when your breaker is tripping as a result of short circuit, you have to make sure that you look for where that particular short circuit is and then rectify it. And you can easily identify a short circuit by doing insulation resistance test. So if you realize that there is a particular line or there is a particular circuit that has very low insulation resistance, then that could be causing the problem. And immediately, what you have to do is that you have to change that particular cable that is shorting with a neutral or an egg. Okay, if you change the cable, you are good to go. One thing that people do that is very dangerous, most of the time when a breaker keeps on breaking, what people do is that they just open the distribution board and replace the breaker with a higher rated breaker. Well, in rare cases, maybe the installer didn't do his calculations well. And so under normal operating conditions, if the circuit breaker is too small for the load it is protecting, it can also do that. That is what we call nuisance breaking or nuisance tripping. It means it's not supposed to trip, but because the right breaker has not been used, that is why it is tripping. If that is the case, then you look at the load and choose the appropriate size of breaker and then connect to it. Now, if that is not the case, for instance, assuming you have a lighting circuit that contains 5 of 20 watt lamps. Okay, so you have 5 of 20 watt lamps that are connected to a 6 amp circuit breaker. And that 6 amp circuit breaker keeps on tripping. You switch it on, it goes off. Sometimes you switch it on and then after a few days, it goes off. When it is happening like that, then there must be a problem. That could mean that there is a leakage in a part of the circuit. A leakage means that there is current leaking from a conductor or from a live conductor to a neutral conductor or from a live conductor to earth. When I say earth, it could be any metal work of the wire. When that happens, it means that in a short time, there will be a short circuit. Now, so you have to correct that. If you suspect leakage, you can do insulation resistance test. Or if you can't do it by yourself, you contact a professional who can help you to do insulation resistance test to be sure that the insulation on your wires are up to standard. Otherwise, if you go and remove that lighting circuit that is tripping the 6-arm breaker, 5 of 20 watt lamps will be 100 watts. Okay, 100 watts divided by 230 volts will give you less than 1 amp. Let's say you are in a jurisdiction where you use 120 volts. Still, 100 watts divided by 120 volts will still be less than 1 amp. And so even if you have 3-amp breaker, that should be enough to protect those 5 lamps. But most of the time, 6 amps is the least, so you will have to use 6 amps. Now, if that 6 amps is tripping, then there must be a problem with one of the lamps, or there must be an insulation problem in the wire. And you have to check that and resolve it. Now, if you go and replace that 6 amp breaker that is tripping, and you go and connect it to 16 amp breaker or 20 amp breaker, what you are simply doing is that you are risking the whole lighting circuit, which consists of the cables, the lamps, and as a result of that small lighting circuit, you can risk the whole wire. This is how it happens. When you connect those 5 lamps or that lighting circuit to a 20 amp breaker, what happens is that the cables that are used for that wiring might be either 1 millimeter squared cable or 1.5 millimeter squared cable. And in some jurisdictions, 1.5 cable
can only carry
about 12 amps current continuously. I am saying in some jurisdictions because when determining the current carrying capacity of cables, a lot of factors come to play.
I'll be talking about these factors in a subsequent video.
In some jurisdictions, 1.5 millimeter squared cable can carry effectively and continuously up to 12 amps current. Now, if that is what that cable can carry, and beyond that, it can overheat and then melt. So it's likely that that cable can melt when the 20 amp breaker is still on. And when it starts melting, it can catch fire. All right, so please, when a breaker keeps on tripping, find out to know why it is happening. Thank you very much. I'll be coming your way with more educative videos. If you like it, let me know. Comment at the comment section. Thank you very much.